Good afternoon, sir and batchmates. Today we are here to present about guerrilla offensive marketing. And our batchmates are Malavika Mohan, Jagdish Reddy, Ganesh, Mohammed Fawaz, Mukul, Pratyusha, Muskan, Neetu Chandran, Nihar, and Ishtaharya.
Awesome. Next slide. Great. All the best.
Nihar, sir, next slide. And we are going to discuss about offensive marketing introduction, and in that frontal attack, flank attack, encirclement attack, bypass attack, and guerrilla attack.
Yes.
Nihar? Coming to offensive marketing, it is generally a competition created among equals. Every company generally have a market share among the competitors. If one company attacks the other company in their business plan or marketing and taking away its market, is actually described as offensive marketing. It is generally used to destabilize the leader or acquire their market share, boost up their sales, and leapfrog the competitor. That means overtaking a competitor.
Yes.
Next slide. And this strategy is suitable when we have a homogeneous market, relatively homogeneous market, and brand equity is low and poorly differentiated. Means if two companies have the same commodity with very little differentiation, then mainly this offensive marketing is suitable. And competitor has less resources. If a customer has a less loyalty, then this offensive marketing we can see. One example of this is Samsung versus Apple. When Apple came up with iPhone in 2007, Samsung introduced their Galaxy series in order to compete with Apple. They introduced Galaxy series in 2013. And they were also good in promotional activities than Apple to compete them in their sales and getting over their market. Next slide.
Yes.
There are different types of strategies in offensive marketing. There are frontal attack, flank attack, encirclement attack, bypass, and guerrilla attacks. This will be explained by our batchmates.
Will be explained by?
Our teammates.
Good, good, Pratyusha. Good job done. Thank you very much. Yes, go ahead. Team 3 doing great job. Go ahead.
So next is about frontal attack. So here, as the name suggests, here the company attacks indirect. That is, it's a head-on attack to the competitor. That is, they'll be focusing directly over the strength of this competitor rather than on the weakness. So it can be taken like they'll be attacking with the similar product, price, quality, promotion, and distribution. Everything would be similar. They'll be attacking with the strength. So in such a case, it is very risky because the attack, unless the attacker has a clear advantage, otherwise it will adversely affect the company. An example could be seen between Pepsi and Coca-Cola. Next slide, please.
Excellent.
So in the case of Pepsi and Coca-Cola, as we know, they are market leaders in the case of carbonated soft drink market, drink. So when Pepsi introduced Diet Pepsi, Coke introduced Diet Coke. So this was an example of a frontal attack.
Yes, definitely. Head on.
Okay, sir. So this is about the flank attack. So now talking about flank attack, you have seen already what is frontal attack. Frontal attack is a direct-to-direct attack. Now in flank attack, the attack is happening into the blind or the weak point of the market leader. We have already discussed that is different kind of market players are there. There is leader is there, challenger is there, you know, according to the division, 40, 30, 20, 10 and like that. So see here. So this is a market leader and the challenger is directly attacking to the weak point either or into the blind spot. So there is a two strategies are there. The strategies, first thing is geographical and segmentalism. If they find, you know, in a certain geography, the particular leader is actually lacking, then you can go for an attack in that geography.
Yes.
Similarly, if it is a segmental, you can see in some particular area or particular, you know, segment, targeted segment, the market leader is lacking the same, yes. You can choose for that. So it is not, it's more strategy, strategical attack rather than that of the frontal attack and power using. Next slide, please.
Exactly.
Next slide, please. Okay, you can see some example here. You know, earlier there was a Robins. Robin was basically a powder you and now it is replaced by Ujala. Ujala is, you know, basically the ad they used it. Aya Ujala Char Bunde Wala. So basically it is more, you know, more useful. Like simply it is available in liquid form. You don't have to mix it with the water. So they directly targeted the weakest point of the robots. Similarly, the next one is, in 1917, Japanese car makers, they acquired small fuel efficient car segments from the US car makers, because US car makers were actually, it is comparatively costly. So the Japanese car makers, they have focused on the fuel efficient and less costly car products actually.
Yes.
Go for the next.
Good job.
Could you please carry on?
Yeah. Thank you. Good job.
Yes.
Your team is doing good.
Flank attack is well explained by Mohammed Fuad, sir. I will add one point there. In the flanking attack, we don't create the demand. We will fulfill the demand which is not fulfilled by the competitor or the leader. And there is two types of flank attack. One is geographical attack, one is geographical flank, and another is segmented. Geographical, where the company can attack in the market where the competitor is not there. Recently, as you see in the example, Coca-Cola is starting their business in that area where the other companies are not there. Next slide, please. In the segmented flank, where the company find the area where the other company is not there. Like Red Bull go the business for the energy drink, not go for the Coca-Cola and other things. So they choose the market where other competitors are not there.
Good one. Good example.
Next slide. Okay, sir.
Good afternoon, sir and batchmates. Now I'm going to explain another type of offensive marketing strategy, that is encirclement attack. It's nothing but it is generally considered as a war strategy which is adopted by challenger firm, which is intended to attack market leader or competitor from all fronts simultaneously. Basically, it's a combination of both frontal and flank attack. And for the in order to proceed with this attack, there are some conditions like the challenger firm must be stronger or powerful when compared to the opponent firm. Then only it is able to launch this type of encirclement attack. And also it must have adequate resources because they have to attack both on strength and weakness. And
yes,
this type of strategy is of basically it can be applied in two methods. Like it can go for product encirclement attack or market encirclement attack. Generally, in product encirclement attack, what happens is the challenger firm introduces different types of product with varied features, quality, and price on basis of their utility. For example, we can see basically this type of product encirclement attack is basically followed by FMCG industries like ITC and HUL. And there is another encirclement attack, that is market encirclement attack. In this, the firm introduces the product for such a segment which is left untapped for the competitor. For example, if we can see 5 years back when Microsoft Windows were getting more popular, the Sun Microsystems given license of this Java software to many developers. So that is the reason why now we find many application softwares based on that Java. It's an example of that market encirclement attack.
Wow. Great. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Who is coming next?
Coming to the bypass attack, it's a strategy adopted by different firms to surpass the competitor. They mostly target easier markets or untapped markets so that there will be no competition for them. The purpose of the strategy is to broaden the firm's resources by capturing the market share of the competing firm. The firm can adopt any of the three approaches that you can see on the slide, right? Either they can go diversify into some unrelated products that the competitor has not invested in, or diverse into a new geographical area where the market presence of their competitor is low. Also, they can leapfrog into some new technology. Leapfrogging means the firm performs a thorough research and launches next generation technology with the intention to attract most customer and shift the battlegrounds to its own territory.
Lovely. Good.
Mostly, just a second, sir. The slide is not changing. Sorry for the technical.
Time up, please. Okay,
this type of approach is mainly prevalent in mobile industry, where the companies launch new technology one after the other to supersede their competitor. Like Apple and Samsung are both the examples, the two well-known companies who follow this bypass attack. any company develops a new technology, another company adds some value to that technology and come up with a new customer oriented technology. Then coming to the, then another is diversifying into unrelated products. This has been done by the Coke and Pepsi. We can Coke launched its brand Aquafina before the Coke's brand Dasani, so that it can tap the market potential and tap the customer before Coke's coming into the market. Thank you.
Okay, great job. Thank you, team three. Please try to close
last. Okay, sir. Yeah. We'll close it in a minute. The last kind of attack is guerrilla attack. This is a strategy which is focusing on low-cost, unconventional tactics. It is mainly used by entry-level firm in a market where competition is very high, which means it uses less amount of money but more of imagination and creativity. The major example was Coca-Cola, between Coca-Cola and Pepsi. This includes viral marketing that can be through social media, then ambient marketing, presence marketing, then the different wild postings. Then they will be relating their product to unrelated ideas, then experimental marketing, alternative marketing. All these comes under guerrilla marketing. Another very common example is that of Big Bazaar. When Big Bazaar entered this, there was very big competition from other firms. And they have come up with some marketing strategies like Wednesday Bazaar, Sabse Sasta Din, the Great Exchange Offer, these kind, which was unheard of in this supermarket sector or hypermarket sector. Yes. So this was experimental and new. That kind of technique was used in a place where competition was really high, but that involved not much of a cost from their side. Thank you.
Okay, very good. Great job. That's very interesting and very good presentation. I like the slides. I like the content. I like the teamwork. I like the understanding among the team members. That's a great job. I think you dealt with the topic, guerrilla, you know, the offensive. It is not defensive. Offense is sometimes the best way of defense. And yes, you help us understand different types of, you know, offensive attacks. It's like a war. It's like a war in the war, how we attack the enemy from different angles. You have beautifully explained. Thank you very much. Let's give a good appreciation to Team 3, please.